welcome to our channel knowledge of friends subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon for the latest update आज हम डेटा वेयर हाउसिंग एंड डेटा माइनिंग की क्लास कर रहे हैं जो कि क्लास नंबर 15 है दैट इज योर क्लास 15 एंड एज वेल एज वी हैड डन योर क्लास 14 हियर एंड इन बिफोर इन दिस क्लास वी हैड डन योर यूनिट 1 एंड यूनिट 2 एंड यूनिट 3 यूनिट 4 and unit 5 as well and the short answers possible question we had done for the unit 1 as well and we are doing unit 2 we had done very memory based questions and we have to do from starting from that is your application based question as of last class as if you have gone through with that so you know that in the short possible questions which is all the short questions of 2 marks possible questions that we are dealing with the in 3 sequence with first is your memory based question then your application based question and the evaluation based question in unit 1 we had done your memory based question application based question as well as evaluation based question and in unit 2 we had done your memory based question now we'll start with the application based question and further we'll go ahead with evaluation based question so today it's a huge request from my side to all the viewers please go through with the subscribe button and please like share and subscribe our channel so that many and maximum people can get the information at once and even though you can also enjoy the video as well the first question of the session for the application based question application based questions so in this that the first question is that diagrammatically show processor requirement we have to show the processor requirement diagrammatically so the processor requirement to be RS to be follows in the processor requirements that what we have to deal with it the following diagram we have So here it is your and then we have So here this will be here and this will go from this is a bi-directional so here in the diagrammatically if I'm talking about here that is your unpredictable DSS this is predictable DSS this is data warehouse processor and this is your background processor processing as well so these were the two connected towards the unpredictable and DSS and that is your predictable DSS and that is a bidirectional and that has been also connected to a test which is also a bidirectional so this is a processor requirement in a diagram now we'll go ahead with other diagram that is application based question the question is with the help of a diagram show the extraction and transformation subsystem so we have to show the extraction and transformation subsystems here So here we go ahead. over here in this. This is your source system tables, or we can say that copies, extraction and transformation subsystem. This is your load image. This is DIM 1, DIM 2, DIM 3, DIM 4, and that is FACTS. This is an extraction and that is your transformation subsystems to be RS, to be follows. Now we'll discuss the another question, that is to represent SMP and MPP system with the help of a diagram. So SMP and MPP system, that to be RS follows. SMP architecture. SMP architecture, MPP architecture, which is so this is MPP architecture. This is your here in this, that is your disk. This is CPU 1, CPU 2, CPU 3. This is memory. This is SMP architecture, where the disk has been connected to the CPU 1, CPU 2, CPU 3, and this is connected to the memory as well. This is MPP architecture. In MPP, SMP architecture, in MPP here, that is your memory is connected to CPU, which is connected to disk. And from memory to the connection to the disk, that has been gone towards the disk as well. This is memory. This is CPU as well. So this has been connected, and that is MPP architecture here. Now we'll go ahead with the detail, which is another question and the last question of the application based questions of unit 2, that is write diagrammatically show the data warehouse software components. So I told you about the extractions and transformation, where the source data, middleware, extraction, transformation, quality assurance, load image convection as well. In warehouse technology, there are the data marts and data warehousing. And for the data access and retrieval, which is, we have OLAP, report writers, ESS, DSS, DSS, and data mining, alerts, system exceptions, reporting, that it comes under in it from the data warehouse here. So that is warehouse technologies. So now let's go ahead with this, and that what we had done even though. And after that, we'll start with the evaluation based question. In the evaluation based question, there are possibly 3 to 4 questions that we'll discuss about it, and that are as to be follows. Evaluation based questions. In the evaluation based questions here, that is the first question of this from unit 2 we have. that is identify the parallel processing architecture. You have to identify the parallel processing architecture. In this, the data is partitioned across all disks and the DBMS is partitioned across multiple core servers. It offers near linear scalability and it is the most difficult architecture to implement as well. So the question is to identify the parallel processing architecture. In this, that the data is partitioned across all disks and core servers. It offers near linear scalability and that the most difficult architecture to implement as well. So you have to guess it out, and the first answer we have shared nothing architecture. The second question we have for the evaluation based question is to identify the type of parallelism. We have to find out the type of parallelism here. In this, that identify the type of parallelism where it occurs among different tasks, like all component query operations are executed in a parallel in a pipelined fashion, and also an output from one task become an input for another task here. That what we have to as given an answer as well. In the same way, that is we'll go ahead with the that question, that identify the type of parallelism where it occurs among the different tasks and all component query operation that are executed in parallel in a pipeline fashion, and also the output from one task become an input for another task. So for that we will have an answer, that is the second answer, which we have is your vertical parallelism. Now we'll go ahead with other one. Now we'll go ahead with other question, that is to identify the figure of the Cuban matrix, where we have an item, locations, and for the sales, and of course time and producers as well. So that we have to answer for that, the for that representation that star represent this task. Now we'll go ahead with other question and the last question of evaluation based question of unit 2, that is to predict the type of parallelism. We have to predict the type of parallelism, and the question is that it refers to the execution of a single query in a parallel on multiple processors and disks. It is important for speeding up long running queries. It decomposes the serial SQL query into a lower level operations here. So I repeat the question here. You have to predict the type of parallelism, that it refers to the execution of a single query in a parallel on multiple processors and disks. It is important for speeding up long running queries. It decomposes the serial SQL query into a lower level operations as well. So the fourth we have intra query parallelism. Now we'll go ahead with another one, that is what we have to understood, what we have to discuss here, and that is here the another question, which is from the unit 3. We will start with that, and in unit 3 the name of the unit, as I told you about it, it is your data mining and reduction. So in the data mining and reduction here, we'll start with the first one, that is your memory based questions. So in the memory based questions here, so first we'll go ahead with the questions as well. Then that the question we have, the first question is, discuss the various factor which facet the growth of data mining, which fueled the growth of data mining, that what we have to discuss here. So discuss the various factors which fueled the growth of the data mining, that has been asked of 2 marks here. That is the growth in the field of the data mining and knowledge discovery has been fueled by the variety of factors. So we'll discuss some of them. That is, the first is that the explosive growth in data collections by businesses. The second is that the storing of the data in the data warehouse for easy and reliable access by the entire enterprises. The third we have is the availability of increased access of data from internet. And the fourth we have is that the growth in computing, the power and storage capacity here. So in the terms of it, we'll go ahead with other question as well. And that is the another one is your, what is the motivation behind data mining? So what is motivation behind data mining we have to discuss. Motivation behind data mining here. And that is in the same case that the data are added on a daily basis to the database, and this makes the databases very large due to wide availability of a huge amount of data, and there is a need for turning such data into useful information and knowledge, and hence the need of extracting the important information from the enormous amount of data motivated the mining of large amount of data as well. So data as well. So let's go ahead with other one. That is another question is to write down the steps in KDD process. So the steps in the KDD process will go ahead. Steps in KDD process. So the steps in the KDD process, we have a 5 steps here. The first is the selection. The second step is your data cleaning and pre-processing. The third is your data transformation. The fourth is your data mining. The fifth is your interpreting mined patterns. So now we'll go ahead with the further one, that what we have to discuss about it, which is another question. What are the components of data mining? So we'll have to discuss about components of data mining here. So here that the components of data mining we have. The first is your database. The second is your data warehouse server. The third we have is your that is in the same cases that we have knowledge base. The fourth we have is your data mining engine. The fifth we have is your pattern evaluation. Module. The sixth we have, and the last, that is your user interface. So we have a 6 components here. The first is your database, the second is your data warehouse server, third is your knowledge base, and fourth is data mining engine, fifth is pattern evaluation module, and the sixth is the user interface here. Now we'll discuss about, list down the various issues that is related to the data mining. So various issues that is related to the data mining here. That is the issues we'll have to discuss about it. The first issue is your privacy issue. The second issue is your data integrity issue. The third issue we have is your that is your relational DB structures or multidimensional one. The fourth is your cost. The fifth is your data quality. And the sixth we have is your interoperability. Now we'll talk about the another one, the another question that what we have to go through with that. So here we'll discuss about the another one, that the another question we have is to define data training. In the terms of the data cleaning here, that the data cleaning is also known as the data cleansing, and it is a phase in which noisy data and irrelevant data that are removed from the collection here. Now, other than that, the possible question up to 2 marks has been that is what is data transformation? So what is data transformation? That it is also known as data consolidation, and it is a phase in which a selected data is transformed into an appropriate form for the mining procedure here. Now we'll discuss about the another question, which is the give various data mining functionalities. So in the functionalities here, that we'll talk about the data mining functionalities here. So the first functionality we have is your characterization. The second we have is your discrimination. That is your discrimination, as I told you. Third, we have association analysis. And the fourth we have is your classification. The fifth we have is your prediction. The sixth is your clustering. The seventh is your outlier analysis. And of course, the next, the last, we have your eighth one, which is evaluation and deviation analysis. Now we'll go ahead to discuss about the another question, that is your what do you mean by characterization. In the characterizations here, that what we'll talk about it, and that is the question here, that is what do you mean by characterization. In this, that the data characterization is a summarization of general features of object in a target class and produces what it is called characteristics rule, and the data relevant to the user specified class that are normally retrieved by a database query as well, that comes under it. In the data discrimination here, that the data discrimination produces what are called discriminant rules, and is basically the comparisons of the general feature of object between the two classes, that is referred to as a target class and contrasting class as well. We'll talk about another one, which is your types of data cleansing and the cleaning that we have. So we'll talk about it. Types of data cleaning. So here in the types of data cleaning, that the first we have is your missing values. The second is your noisy data, where the first we have is your binning technique.
B is your clustering. C is your combined computer. And human inspection. The fourth is your regression. In noisy data. Noisy data has been divided into four categorization, that is binning technique, clustering, combined computers and human inspections and regression. And the third type we have here is your inconsistent data. So in all total, the types of data cleaning we have, the first is missing value, second is noisy data, and third is inconsistent data. And noisy data has been divided into four, which is binning technique, clustering, combined computers and human inspection, and then regression here. So that I will talk about. In the talking about binning technique here, that what is binning technique. So binning method, smooth assorted data value by resulting its neighborhood, that is the value around it, and the sorted values are distributed into a number of buckets or bins as well. Now we'll talk about defined regression here. In the regressions here, that the data can be smoothened by filtering, that fitting the data to a function, and such as with regression. And linear regression involves finding the best line to fit two attributes, so that one attribute that can be used to predict the other as well. Now we'll talk about the steps in data transformation. So the steps in data transformations here that we have. So the steps we have are as follows. That is, the first we have is your steps in the data transformations. That is, first is your smoothing. The second is your aggregation. The third is your generalization. Fourth is normalization. The fifth we have is your attribute construction. Now we'll talk about another one, which is what is Z-score normalization. So the Z-score normalization, that what we have to go ahead with the detailed about it. And let's go ahead here. Z-score, that is your normalization. In Z-score normalization here, in this type of a normalization, the mean of the transformed set of data points we have here, and with the type that the mean of that the transformed set of data points is reduced to zero. For this, the mean and standard deviations of the initial set of the data values that are required, and that the transformation formula for this we have V dash equals to V minus A bar upon sigma of A here. Now we'll go ahead with the discussion about the detailed here. That is, where the A bar here, that and L, that sigma A, that the mean and standard deviations of the initial data values here. Now we'll go ahead with another one, that is to give various strategies for the data reduction. So the strategies we'll discuss about it. Strategies for data reduction. So strategies for the data reductions, we have five strategies. So the first strategy we have, which is data cube aggregation. The second is your attribute subset selection. third is your dimensionality reduction. And the fourth is numerosity reduction. The fifth we have is your discretizations and the concept hierarchy generations. Now we'll go ahead to discuss about another one, which is what is attribute selection method. And in the attribute selection method, attribute subset, that is your selection method here, that reduces the data sizes by removing the irrelevant attribute. And the goal of the attribute subset selection is to find a minimum set of attributes such that the resulting probability distributions of the different data classes that gives the value for those attribute, and which is as close as possible to original distributions obtained using all attribute as well. Now we'll discuss about right on the basic techniques of heuristics method for the attribute selection. So in the heuristic method, we have your forward backward basic technique for the heuristic method for the attribute selection. We have the first is your forward selection, backward selection, combination of forward selection and a backward elimination, and as well as the decision tree induction. That comes under the basic technique of the heuristics method for the attribute selection. Now we'll talk about right short on dimensionality reduction. In this process, that the data encoding or transformation that are applied to obtain or reduce representations of the original data. If the original data that can be reconstructed from the compressed data without any loss of information, the data reduction is called lossless. If the data can be reconstructed only approximated of the original data, then the reduction is called lossy here. Now we'll talk about the another one, which is your explain PCA. In the term of the PCA, first we'll go ahead with the full form of PCA here, and that is principle principle component analysis. Principle component analysis, that is a technique used to reduce multidimensional data sets to the lower dimensional for analysis here. PCA is mostly used as a tool in exploratory data analysis and for making predictive models. In PCA, that can be used for the dimensionality reduction in the data set by retaining those characteristics of the data set that are contribute most to its variance, and by keeping the lower order PC and ignoring higher ones as well. Now we'll go ahead with another one, that what we have to discuss is what is numerosity reduction here. In the numerosity reduction, that numerosity reduction technique that can be applied to reduce the data volume by choosing alternative smaller forms of data representation. And in this data that are replaced or estimated by a smaller data, and the representation that can be parametric or non-parametric as well. Now we'll discuss about some of list down the techniques that is used in the numerosity reduction. So that is, we have the first technique, we have regression and log linear models. Second is your histogram. Third is clustering, and fourth is sampling here. Now we'll go ahead with another one, which is write a short note on a discretization that we have here. In discretizations here, that the discretization technique that can be used to reduce the number of values for a given continuous attribute by dividing the attribute into a range of intervals and interval value labels that can be used to replace the actual data values. These data are typically recursive. The large amount of the data is spent on sorting of the data at each step, and many discretization techniques that can be applied recursively in order to provide a hierarchical or a multi-resolution partitioning of the attribute value, that is known as concept hierarchy here. Now we'll go ahead with another one, which is your what is your concept hierarchy generations. So in the concept hierarchy, that is a directed acyclic graph of the concept, where each of the concept is identified by a unique name, and an arc that from a concept A to B that denotes A is a more general concept than B, and we can tag the text with the concept, and each text document is tagged by a set of the concept that corresponds to its content as well. Now we will go ahead with another one, which is to give the technique of discretizations and concept hierarchy generations from numeric data. So the method for the concept hierarchy generation for the numeric data, we have the first is binning, second is histogram analysis, third is your cluster analysis, that even though we had discussed in a detail as well. The other memory based question that we have to discuss is mention the technique of the concept hierarchy. In that same case, the mention the technique of the concept hierarchy generation for a categorical data. That is, the techniques of the concept hierarchy generation for the categorical data are, that is, your specification of a partial ordering of attribute explicitly at the scheme, that is schema level by expert, and the specification of only a partial that set of attributes, and of course the specification of the portion of the hierarchy by the explicit data grouping as well. Now we'll discuss about the application based question. In application based question here, that the diagrammatically that show the steps in the KDD process, we have to show the steps in the KDD process. The initial data is your the selection, then the target data is pre-processing, then processed data, that is your transformation, then we have transfer data, and then we have interpretation, and then we have, you know, steps in KDD. We had done that in a detail when we had gone through with the unit. You can just go through with that as well. Now we'll go ahead here, the another one, that is the steps in KDD we had done as we had discussed about it. Now we'll go ahead with other one, that is another question. Depict the forms of data pre-processing with the help of diagrams. So forms of data pre-processing we have here. That what we have to discuss as well. So here in the same cases, we'll go ahead with the steps in KDD, and that is the first year step we have is your initial data, then we have your target data, and then we have here is your that is your pre-processed data. And then we have here is your transferred data, and then we have your interpretation, and of course that we have here in the form of here. So in the same cases, we'll talk about the initial data here. That is your knowledge. This is your selection. This is pre-processing. This is transformation. And this is your data mining. And of course, that is your model. Now in the same cases here, the initial data, that is your target data, that is pre-processed data, this is transformed data, and that is your interpretation. And diagram that has been represented. These were the steps in KDD. Now we'll discuss to depict the form of the data pre-processing with the help of a diagram, as I told you about it, and that what we have to discuss as well. So here we have evaluation process, then we have data mining, then of course we have hypothesis selection, then we have analytical and reduction, then we have data cleaning, and then we have data collecting. This was the data pre-processing task. In the same cases, we will talk about it, that is your evaluation. The another we have is your data mining. Hypothesis selection. Analyzing reduction. Data cleaning. Data collecting. This is your data pre-processing step. This is your analyzing step. So here from the data collecting, it goes towards data cleaning, then analyzing and reduction, then hypothesis selection, data mining, evaluation. And evaluation has been gone towards, and the data mining gone towards analyzing step here. And hypothesis selection and analyzing and reduction, that goes towards the pre-processing data, that is your data cleaning as well, and the data collecting as well, that comes under the data pre-processing task. Now we'll go ahead with the question that what we have to discuss, that the last question in reference towards the third unit application based questions. The question is that suppose that the mean and the standard deviations of the value for the attribute income, that are is $54,000 and 16,000 respectively. So it means that the mean is your $54,000 and standard deviation is your 16,000 respectively. So you have to apply z-score normalization on the value $73,600. So z-score normalization, what we have to find it out. So just write it on the given things, and that is your the mean equals to $54,000 and standard deviation equals to $16,000, and of course that the z-score normalization, that is equals to $73,600. So that's what we have to solve it out. We'll go ahead. Z-score normalization, that is u dash equals to u minus a bar upon sigma of a. We're in the same case. 73,600 minus 54,000 upon 16,000, and that is equals to, when we'll subtract this and divide by 1000, we will be finding out 1.225. That will be the right answer, u dash, that in the form of z square, that normalization when we are applying it to it. Now we'll go ahead with other question, that is in the terms of evaluation based questions. in the terms of evaluation based question, the first question we have that you have this data pre-processing form has the following approaches. The first approach is your data analysis, verification, transformation, backflow of the cleaned data, and definition of the transformation workflow and mapping rules. You have to identify the data pre-processing form. So the data pre-processing form that it goes towards the data analysis, verification, transformation, backflow of the cleaned data, and definition of transformation workflow and mapping rules. So you that we have to identify the data pre-processing form, and that is we have as offensive that as I told you about it that it follows, and you have to find out the identify the data pre-processing form. So the form we have, the answer will be data cleaning. The next we have your question, that is the second question of the evaluation based questions here. The other question is that in this data reduction method, that data encoding or transformation that are applied so as to obtain a reduced or compressed representation of original data, it can be used for removing irrelevant and redundant attribute at the time of the data reduction method. That is the question I repeat itself, that is the question is that in this data reduction method, data encoding or transformation are applied so as to obtain a reduced or compressed representation of original data. It can be used for removing irrelevant and redundant attributes at the time of the data reduction method as well. So the answer is your dimensionality reduction. Third question of the session that we have your evaluation based questions here, that is to predict the data reduction technique. You have to predict the data reduction technique, that is in this data volume is reduced by choosing alternating smaller forms of data representations, and in this there is no loss of data but whole data is represented in a smaller form. Repeat the question here, that is the evaluation based questions, that is in this you have to predict the data reduction technique here. So here we have a third question, that is we have to predict the data reduction technique. In this data volume that is reduced by choosing alternative and smaller forms of the data representation, in this there is no loss of data but whole data is represented in a smaller form, and that the answer we have is your numerosity reduction. Other question we have here is that has been arrived, that is another question, that it can be used for dimensionality reduction in a data set by retaining those characteristics of the data set that contribute most of its variance, and that the result here and in the same cases that the results are usually discussed in the terms of components scores and loading, and identify the dimensionality reductions method as well. Here in the same case, the question I repeated, that has been your the evaluation based questions, which is it can be used for dimensionality reduction in the data set by retaining those characteristics of data set that contribute most of its variance, and the results that are usually focused in the terms of the component scores and loading, identify the dimensionality reduction method. So the dimensionality reduction method that we have to identify is your principal component analysis. The answer we have is your the principal component analysis. That is your PCA. Now we'll talk about the another question here, that is this attribute subset selection technique constructs a flowchart like structure where each internal node denotes a test on an attribute, each branch corresponds to an outcome of the test, and each external node denotes class prediction. name the technique here. So the question is that this attribute subset selection technique constructs a flowchart like structures here. So with the same concept that the flowchart like structures where each internal node denotes a test on an attribute and each branch corresponds to an outcome of the test and each external node denotes a class prediction, you have to name the technique here so that you the technique will be your the answer, that is your which is your decision tree induction. Another question we have is which is this technique combines data from multiple sources into a coherent store and or a data set. It involves the sources like various databases, flat files and data cubes, etc. The typical issue that needs to be resolved are checking attribute names in a different database. You have to predict the technique. The question is, I repeat it, that this technique combines data from multiple sources into a coherent stores or a data set. It involves the sources like various databases, flat files, data cubes, etc. The typical issues that are need to be resolved are checking attribute name in a different databases, and you have to predict the technique as I told you about it. The technique is your data integration. The sixth evaluation is, the answer is data integration. Now we'll go ahead with the discussion about it, and that is in the detailed about the unit 4, which is your classification and clustering. Classification and clustering, there we'll discuss about memory based question. So here, that is unit 4 is your classification and clustering, that is memory based questions here. The first question we'll discuss in the terms of it, which is, what do you mean by concept description? In the terms of the concept description, that what we will have to talk about it. That is your concept description. In the concept description, that is the most basic form of descriptive data mining. It describes a given set of task relevant data in a concise and a summative manner, presenting interesting general properties of data. It can be derived by the data characterization and data discrimination, and both data characterization and discrimination as well. Talk about the second one, which we have is your explain data discrimination. In this data discrimination, where the data discrimination is a comparison of the general features of target class data object with the general features of the object from one or a set of contrasting classes. It can be implemented using the attribute oriented inductions or the data cube approaches as well. We'll go ahead with the other one, that is your what is data generalization. In the data generalization, that is the data generalization is a process that abstract a large set of task relevant data in a database from a relatively low conceptual level to the higher that is conceptual level. And the data generalization summarizes the data by replacing the relatively low level values with the higher level concepts as well. Now we'll go ahead with the detailed about it, and which is your the other question that we'll talk about it, and the other is your write a short note on analytical characterization. In analytical characterization, where analytical characterization performs attribute and dimension relevance analysis in order to filter out irrelevant or a weakly relevant attribute prior to the induction process, and the measures of the attribute relevance analysis that can be used to help in identification of irrelevant or a weakly relevant attribute that can be excluded from the concept description process. Now we'll discuss about the another one, which is to explain the attribute-oriented induction approach. With this, that attribute-oriented induction approach, it is a relational database query-oriented generalization-based online data analysis technique, and there are the several techniques of attribute-oriented induction approach. The first is your data focusing, second is your attribute generalization control, third is data generalization by the attribute removal, the fourth is the generalization data visualization. The fifth is your count and aggregate value, that is your accumulation here. Now we'll go ahead with other one, that what we have to discuss. The another one is list down the various measures of central tendencies. Various measures of central tendencies. So various measures of central tendencies, we'll talk about it. There are various measures of central tendencies to be RS to be follows here, and that what we have here is your mean, second is your median, the third is your mode, and the fourth is your mid range. Now we'll talk about the another one, the another questions here, and that is in the terms of it, which is to explain measuring the dispersion of data. So measuring the dispersion of data here. We have here, that is measuring the dispersion of data. Where in the same cases here, that the degree to which the numerical data tend to spread is called the dispersion or variance of the data. The dispersion is a measure of the variations of the items as well. We'll talk about the various measures of dispersion of data here. So here, that is comes under the various range that we'll talk about it, and in the same cases we'll go ahead with the first we have is your range, the second is your quartiles, outliers and box plot, that is the second we have is your variance. So the third we have here is your quartiles, outliers and box plots, and the fourth we have, the last we have, is your standard deviation. Now we'll talk about the another one, which is the another question here, and that is what are the various graphs used for the display of data summarizes and distributions as well. So then that will discuss about it. Various graphs graphs used to display basic statistical class description so that we have here. The first is your histogram. The second is your quantile plot. The third we have is your quantile plot. The fourth we have is your scatter plot. And the fifth we have is Lyce curve. So the other question is that can arise here, that is, what is Lyce curve? So here in the Lyce curve, it is an important exploratory graphic aid that adds to a smooth curve and to a scatter plot in order to provide a better perceptions of pattern of dependence. And the word Lyce is a short for a large local regression here. We'll go ahead with the other one, that is to explain decision tree based algorithm. In the decision tree based algorithm, that we'll talk about it. The decision tree based algorithm here we have that it is an important approach to the classification problem, and the approach is to divide the several space into the rectangular region. It is of four types, and that is, the first you have your ID3, the second is your C4.5, the third we have is your CART, and the fourth we have, that is, scalable DT techniques. So now we'll go ahead with the discussion about which is your issues in DT algorithm. In the issues in the algorithm, that there are some issues in the decision tree algorithm, which is to choosing the splitting attribute or ring of splitting attribute, splits, tree structures, or stopping criteria, training data, pruning that comes under in it. And now we'll discuss about define ID3 decision tree algorithm here. That is the ID3 decision algorithm, which is that this is the decision tree algorithm in which the attributes are chosen in any order for the CLS algorithm, and this can be result in the large decision tree if the ordering is not optimal, where the ID3 is equals to CLS plus efficient ordering of the attribute as well. We'll talk about some of the things in the terms of it, which is about tree pruning, and talking about the tree pruning, where that the decision that tree take that can to contain many branches, which will reflect the anomalies in the training data due to the noise and outliers. The method addresses this problem of overfitting the data, and such method typically uses statistical measure to remove at least reliable branches, resulting in the faster classification as well. Now we will go ahead with another class. We'll continue with the next classes here, and that is we'll have to discuss here. First of all, we here will end up with, and the next we'll discuss some of the memory based questions as well as the application, as well as in the reference towards that is your the another one as well, and that is your evaluation based question. So here we end up with, and in the data warehouse in the process and technology, that we are doing the first unit, which is your data warehouse, and that is your overview, definition, data warehousing, components, building a data warehouse, warehouse database, mapping the data warehouse in the multiprocessor architecture, difference between the database system and the data warehouse, multi-dimensional data models, data cubes, stars, snowflakes, pack constellation, concept hierarchy, process architecture, three-tier architecture, and data marting as well. And unit 2, which is your data warehouse process and technology, that is your warehouse strategies, warehouse management and support process, warehouse planning and implementation, hardware and operating systems for the data warehousing, client server computing models and the data warehousing, parallel processors and cluster system, distributed DBMS implementation, warehousing software, warehouse schema design, data extraction, cleanup and transformation tool, and warehouse metadata as well. Then we had start with unit 3rd, which we had completed, that is your data mining and reduction, where that is your overview, motivation, definition and functionality, data processing, form of the data, pre-processing, data cleaning, missing values, noisy data, binning, clustering, regressions, computers and human inspection, inconsistent data, data integrations and transformation, data reduction, data cube aggregation, dimensionality reduction, data compression, numerosity reduction, discretizations and the concept hierarchy generation and the decision tree as well. Then we had started with the unit 4, which we had up till date, and that is your classification and clustering, which is we had covered up the classification, definition, data generalization, analytical characterizations, analysis of the attribute relevance, mining class comparisons, statistical measures in the large databases, statistical based algorithm, distance based algorithm, decision tree based algorithm, clustering, introduction, similarities in the distance measure, hierarchical and a partitional algorithm, hierarchical clustering, cure and chameleon, density based method, DB scan, optics, grid based method, sting click, model based method, statistical approach, association rule, interaction, large time set, item set, basic algorithm, parallel and distributed algorithm, neural network approach as well. In unit 5th, which is your data visualization, that is aggregation, historical information, query facility, OLAP functions and tools, OLAP servers, ROLAP, MOLAP, OLAP, data mining interface, security, backup and recovery, tuning, data warehouse, testing data warehouse, warehouse application and recent trends, types of warehousing application, web mining, spatial mining and temporal mining as well. Even though we had discussed, we had to start discussing a very short answer type question, where we had covered up the unit 1 short answer possibly 2 marks questions, unit 2 we had covered up, unit 3 we are going to cover up, like we had started memory based questions where we have done some of the things, and in the next coming class we will start discussing about more in the detail as well. So here we will end up with it, and first of all, it's a huge request from my side to all the viewers, please go through with the subscribe button and please like, share and subscribe our channel so that many and maximum people can get the information at once, and even though you can also enjoy the video as well. And it's a huge request to all the viewers that we are doing the verbal reasoning and non-verbal reasoning, where we had covered up the verbal reasoning here, and we are doing data warehouse and data mining as you can see here, and we are doing we had completed PPL, that is the principle of programming languages. We are going to do geomanagerial economics, and we are going to do quantitative aptitude, and as well as we are doing the computer graphics as well, and the DBMS, that is database management system, we are doing here. So here we'll end up with, thank you, hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up and give a suggestion in the comment box. Thank you. Yeah.